nice to see you today. Thursday morning, 14th day of March. Right. And I want to tell you, March has been pretty good to us so far, hasn't it? Hasn't been too bad. Not too bad. But you know, they say when it comes in like a lamb, it may go out like a lion. So we may have a few blizzards before this is over. All you can do is hope for the best. Expect the worst and take what you get. My grandmother used to say that, and my grandmother was right, exact. Grandmothers know best, don't they? You bet your life they do, Mama. Mama, you're here bright and early this morning. Did you come to see how Amy Simon, our guest on Hobby Corner, is going to make cornhusk dolls? Are you interested in that? I know, make lovely gifts, just a, it's an old hobby, an ancient one. One that you find cornhusk dolls for sale a great deal down in the mountains, in North Carolina, Tennessee, down in Georgia, and places like that, because a lot of the mountain women make those. It's a hobby that goes back many, many years in our history in this country, and I think is really only done in this country, because really, you know, this is where corn started here, and that's where you find corn husks. Right, absolutely. They were not growing corn over in Europe when the Indians were growing corn over here, which they called maize. So it's a hobby that is sort of belongs with this country. And it's an interesting thing, too. Amy's going to show us how you do it. Very interesting. Why don't you get me the little theater screen so we can get the show started? We have a lot to do today. Clutch Cargo is here with the first chapter in the story of the Rocket Riot. And then Amy Simon will be in Hobby Corner. We'll also have a cartoon, the story of Pedro and Lorenzo, and we'll have a visit with Max the Mouse, who's going to tell the story of John Glenn, a name you might have forgotten, but you really shouldn't, because he was the first American to orbit the Earth. So let's take a look at the little theater screen. We get things started with a new Clutch Cargo adventure, part one in the story of the Rocket Riot in 1 minute. Amy Simon lives on Wesley out in Evanston, Illinois, and she wrote to us and said, I'm 10 years old and I have a hobby of making corn shuck dolls, and I'd like to be on your show. I have made the two which I would like to show you, and I also would like to show you how to make them. Sincerely, Amy Simon. Well, we had not seen anyone make corn husk or corn shuck dolls, whichever you choose to call them, because husks and shucks are just about the same thing, aren't they, Amy?
Yeah.
10 years old. Do you have any brothers or sisters?
Two.
Two of what?
I have one sister and one brother.
How old is your sister?
She's 14 and my brother's 12.
Good. Where do you go to school?
At Oakton School in Evanston.
In Evanston. Fine. How long have you been doing this?
6 months ago.
What got you interested to them? Did you interested in this? Did you see some corn husk dolls someplace?
Well, my parents went to Washington. They brought me back this kit, and then I got interested, and I made some more. And I went to our supermarket and started, you know, off on making them.
Went to the supermarket. What'd you get at the supermarket?
I got the shucks.
Did you? You mean from real corn?
Mm-hmm.
And what'd you do? You dried those out.
Right.
Because you make the dolls from the dried husks or shucks, don't you? So you made some from the real thing. Now, people can buy these shucks or husks in hobby stores, did you tell me?
Yeah,
you can buy that because it has become quite a hobby. How did it really start? Why did people make corn husk dolls, Amy?
Well, the pioneer days, they didn't have fancy materials, so they just used what they had.
That's right, they did, and there were plenty of corn husks around, weren't there?
Mm-hmm.
So the women found out how to do it, the pioneer women did, and it's come down to us as a sort of a hobby. Don't handle that, honey, because it makes a lot of noise when you handle that mic cord. All right, let's see how we do it, Amy. What do you start out with? Let's begin over here. Let's start with the products we use. That's right.
Well, you can buy these at your supermarket.
Supermarkets?
I mean, your hobby stores.
Hobby stores, yes. You can buy corn in the summertime when corn comes on the market. You can